Hi everyone, Peter here from Flow High Performance, and in this video, we'll be covering how to train to improve acceleration speed. First, we need to establish what acceleration is. Essentially, acceleration ability is when an athlete goes from a point of little or no momentum and increases their running speed to maximum or near maximum velocity. A classic example of this is during the 100 meter sprint, where the athletes start stationary in the blocks and increase their running speed to maximum over the first 30 to 50 meters. However, many other athletes can also benefit from faster acceleration ability. Athletes playing field sports are often required to suddenly sprint from a walking or standing position. Acceleration differs slightly in its underlying qualities to maximum velocity running, which means that training for acceleration is slightly different to training for max speed. We will now explore what characteristics are prevalent during the performance of acceleration sprinting. The movement technique of acceleration running has some unique elements. Most notably, acceleration is best achieved with a forward lean of the torso. This shifts the center of mass in front of the legs so that each stride is literally pushing the torso forward rather than just directly up. This propels the body forward in the intended direction. There is also generally greater hip flexion during acceleration running compared with maximum velocity running. This means that the quads and glutes are utilized through a greater range of motion. There is also longer ground contact times during each stride when accelerating compared with max speed running. This means that there is a longer duration of time for the athlete to produce force into the ground. Therefore, maximum strength and high force power will contribute more to acceleration performance. Although these characteristics are generally seen during early acceleration running, there is no distinct point where acceleration running ends and maximum velocity running takes over. It is simply a gradual shift from one style to the other, with many variations between the two extremes. Now that we have covered the characteristics of acceleration running, let's now explore how we can best train acceleration. We have three key training methods that can positively enhance acceleration performance. These are speed training, power training, and strength training. The first training method is specific speed training. We need to actually practice the skill that we are trying to improve. To focus specifically on acceleration development, it is best to use short distances of around 10 to 30 meters. This is because the acceleration mechanics of running will be most emphasized during the early portion of a sprint. Any low starts will be good options for acceleration development. Exercises such as push-up starts, two-point starts, block starts, falling starts, etc. will put the athlete into a forward-leaning position to sprint from. These sprints should be performed with maximal intent and given enough rest to fully recover between efforts. This can be periodized by slowly increasing the distances of the sprints over time. This will allow the athlete to build the transition to maximal speed sprinting. For example, a 9-week periodized program may look something like this. We start with shorter distances of 10 meters and slowly transition to distances of 30 meters. The next most specific form of acceleration training is resisted sprinting. Resisted sprints will demand greater force production in a highly specific manner. They will also reiterate the forward lean of the body and the high knee position. Resisted sprints can be performed by using sleds, resisted rope devices, parachutes, or hills. Again, distances of 10 to 30 meters would be best suited to this type of training. This can be periodized by starting with shorter distances and heavier loads to longer distances and lighter loads. This will build the force production qualities first and slowly transfer them to faster running speeds. For example, a 9-week periodized program may look something like this. We start with shorter distances and heavier loads and transition to lighter loads over time with longer distances. The next training modality that can enhance acceleration performance is power training. By power training, we are referring to moving external loads in a ballistic nature, meaning that there is no deceleration phase during the exercise. Power training allows greater force production in an explosive manner. If an athlete can move more weight with the same speed, or the same weight with greater speeds, then acceleration performance is likely to be enhanced. It is important to select exercises which have no deceleration phase. Exercises like squat jumps, medicine ball throws, and trap bar jumps are great options. It is also important to move as fast as possible, regardless of how heavy the load is. The best way to periodize power training is to start with heavier loads, and therefore slower movement speeds, and transition to lighter loads and faster movement speeds. For example, a 9-week periodized program may look something like this. We have chosen the squat jump, where we start with heavier loads and therefore slower movement velocities, and we transition slowly to lighter loads and therefore faster movement speeds. And the last method to enhance acceleration performance is maximal strength training. This will allow absolute force production to be greater. However, the former methods of training should be the priority when training for acceleration because they are more specific. So even if force production is increased, it won't transfer to acceleration performance unless the specific skill is trained simultaneously. The exact exercises selected for maximal strength training don't actually matter to any significant degree since the movement pattern is not specific to running anyway. So any exercise which allows high forces to be produced will be adequate. Exercises like squats, deadlifts, trap bar deadlifts, etc. are all good options. Periodization of strength training for acceleration should follow a linear periodization model. This means that over time, the loads are increased and the reps performed decreases. For example, a 9-week periodized program may look something like this. We start with higher reps and lighter loads and transition into lower rep strength training with heavier loads. This will allow the highest force to be produced at the time we need to be at our peak. Thanks for watching, and hopefully you got something out of this video. Remember to subscribe if you haven't already.